going to see is earlier video continuation DQ. Executing the DQ operations of a queue using linked list. Here already we have seen the structure. Let us consider this is the structure of the linked list, that is queue structure. So front is pointing to the first node and rear is pointing to the last node of the queue. Now we are going to remove. So a removal in a queue can be done only from the front pointer. The front will be made to point to the next location, then this can be removed. So how to do that programmatically? Now we will see. So here, if you see DQ, when you execute DQ, what will happen? Now initially a pointer is made to point to the first node. Okay. Now if we are checking whether node is that is any value is in the queue, that must be some node in the queue, then only you can remove. So first we check whether is empty. Is empty will return a 1 if the queue is empty, or else will return a 0. So if it is queue is empty, you cannot delete. There must be some value to delete, isn't it? So if there is queue is empty, you cannot delete. Now you exit the else portion. According to this, at this point of time, the queue is not empty. It has some values. Some 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 values are there. Now we are going to remove. Always you have to remove only from the front. So now what we do is, before removal, we first assign this to some temporary pointer. That's what we are doing. So in del data, it's a variable where we place this front is pointing now. Here, front is still pointing this. So this data, we write it into a temporary variable according to this front data. Then we assign the pointer to point to the front. Now here, PTR is pointing this. Then this front pointer is moved to point to this according like this. So the front is front to next means it is 101. Now it is pointing here. Now this is no more pointing this. Now this has been cut. So you can access a queue only from the front pointer. So here now it is to 10 is no more available. It is not at all in the queue. Now you have to release the memory space occupied by this. So now you check whether if front is equal to null. Why we are doing whether it has read after removal. Say for example, I am removing this, I am removing this, I am removing this, I am removing this. When I remove front equal to front next mean now it points to the null, which means there is no element. So in that case also you have to modify accordingly. So if front has is null, which means there may be only one element, now you are removing or you execute so many DQ, finally you have reached the end of the list. So in that case also what you have to do is already front is equal to null, so you make rear all to null. So you may saying that the queue is empty, or else now since there are elements now this so after doing that you delete the PTR. Now what is it here? If front is it null only, here it will go, or else simply this pointer will be the node which is pointed by this PTR will be deleted. Already we have moved front to point to this. Then return the del data. What data we are removing? Already we have stored this value 10 here. That will be returned to the main program. So that in main program we can print which data we have removed from the queue. Now we'll see print and destroy operations. Print is nothing but each element in the queue will be printed in this way. That is after 10, 20, 30, 40 and 60. So starting from front till rear. Now, so here, let us see here it is print queue. Now we declare a temporary pointer PTR and PTR is made to point to the front. Then using this pointer, we first print the value in the data position. Then we move to the next. We put it in the while location, while loop. So till it reaches the null. So till pointer is not equal to null, we just print the value which is pointed by this, the data portion. And then we move the pointer to pointer next. So now it is after printing this, the PTR is pointing this. After that, it is pointing this and so on. And finally, when it has reached this, it comes out. Now we will see destroy queue. But print queue and destroy queue is different. Print queue is just printing the value. So you should not move the front and rear. Using a temporary pointer only, you print the value. Whereas here, destroy queue, you are completely removing. So you have to move the pointer itself. You have to modify the front pointer itself. So now, temporarily, we are declaring a pointer, and both are initially here while front is not equal to null. So we are going to move front next. So pointer equal to front. Now it is pointing this. Now after that, we make front to move to the next. The front itself we are moving. So now we lose this value, but this is pointed by the pointer. Now we delete so that the memory space occupied by this is released. Now front is pointing this. Now again pointer is made to point to this. Then we make front to point to this. Now pointer is pointing this. Now we reload and so on till we reach the end of the thing. Finally, we made rear also to be null so that the whole queue is all the nodes in the queue will be removed from the memory. The next one is peak and size. Peak is nothing but printing the value which is pointed by the front, and size is at any point of time how many nodes are there, how many elements are there in our queue. So first we will see peak. Here if there is empty, then you cannot print anything. Since it is already queue is empty, what you can print? But if there is data, then else if it returns a zero, then data in front is front data. You print front and data you print, that's all. Then size queue, for that you keep a count. So initially you are completely traversing the queue, that's the meaning. So count initially it is made to zero, then you allocate a temporary pointer just like our print queue. So first pointer is made to point to the front. While pointer reaches the end of the list, that is when pointer is not equal to null, then pointer equal to pointer next. Now you move this. Then you increment the counter. Since you have counted one, after you move, you have counted one. So count plus plus and so on. So when it reaches the null, finally 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Count will return the value 5. That is number of elements in this is 5. So nothing is disturbed. It just count how many elements are there in our queue.